Hey everybody, welcome back to Pixel
Junkie. For fuck's sake, someone intro!
We're playing 007 Bloodstone.
You can intro, just fucking start already, come on.
Jesus.
Why?
Hey everybody, welcome back to Pixel Junkies. We're playing 007 Bloodstone. I'm Rory, I'm playing. We're all here.
Are we?
We're still here.
I showed up in partway through this series and just took over.
Yeah, that's good, because Rory's better at it than everybody, and I'm fucking done with rage. There's two guys behind that desk there, or whatever it is. Blackjack table.
Oh. What was that?
Oh, there's a dead guy. What is that?
Random noises.
Is that Futurama or something?
Well, that guy's just doing a yoga position right
yeah.
there.
Oh, yeah, and he's just stretching his calves.
Guys, you ever think that you might be retarded?
No. Why would I think that?
I'm just wondering, like, you ever think that you think
Wes,
what's wrong with that guy?
He's coming. He's coming.
Way,
oh no!
And nobody else.
What? What a fight!
That was the most
what a
lazy
fucking fight!
Fucking goddamn push! Like, yeah.
I don't have.
If that anymore. Happens to me tomorrow, I'm gonna be so upset.
But imagine how much of a boss the other goons think. It's like that guy ran across the room getting fired at by bot, and then one hit him into oblivion. They're like, "Holy shit!"
He just got his hands behind his by his sides, and then just kneels down and dies. What a fucking stupid way! They just had the exact same dying animation.
You guys ever see the movie Pitch Perfect?
I think he was gonna say Pitch Black
good,
for a
well,
second.
Well, it is
Anna Kendrick, who's amazing.
Mm-hmm.
So for those who don't know,
that's the only reason to watch.
For those in the audience who don't know, I study computer science, and I had a dream that all the undergraduates in computer science were split off in rival a cappella groups. There were five
what?
Of them. Groups A through E, and I was in group C. But for some reason, like I was upset. I didn't like the leader of our group, so I staged this plot to like overthrow him
wait
or
for
her.
The movie.
I forget. And it was kind of sketchy, and for some reason involved, like, some rather shady behavior. And, so ultimately what happened was I did successfully take over Group C and take charge, but...
But then you realize you didn't know how to sing?
Their consciences got to them, the rest of my team, and we started to lose morale. Some guys were real troopers and tried to keep it going,
was
but
there
it
any
just
singing
didn't work.
In this dream?
Yes.
There was?
Yeah.
Did you sing?
Yes.
Oh.
Oh, this was a dream?
Yes.
Oh.
Yeah, we weren't actually divided into rival a cappella groups.
I thought
and,
this was real.
Yeah, so some of the guys started leaving Team C, and the team just fell apart from there. Mm. And it was a real tragedy. And we also... So, for those who also don't
team
know,
C.
Our university has a bar for students. But this... It's, like, not crazy busy, but this one was crazy busy, and every student hung out in there, and that's where we would hold our competitions and practices and such.
Oh.
It was inspired by the film Pitch Perfect.
Hmm.
It was inspired by.
I imagine.
Sounds like you just fucking brain farted out some stupid ass dream. Or
do your dreams have intro credits?
Code competitions.
starring Rory and friends. Inspired by Pitch Perfect.
I know it was inspired by Pitch Perfect because we sang one of the songs from Pitch Perfect.
Was Fat Amy in your dream? Was Fat Amy a coder?
No, I don't think so, no.
Oh.
I invented a lot of random characters. My subconscious just likes to invent characters. There were only a few actual Comp Sci undergrads.
There was a bunch of you? There was like 18 Rorys?
I didn't like the movie because...
You didn't like Pitch Perfect?
No!
You said you liked it before.
It was
why didn't you
it
like
was
it?
Watchable.
What's the problem?
Because of things like Fat Amy.
You gotta have comedy.
Her entire character was her name.
Yeah, her character was annoying. Okay.
It was an incredibly shallow movie.
I liked the vomit bit.
The music was really good.
What vomit bit?
Someone threw up on the floor or something and they kept slipping in. It was stupid.
It was dumb.
The music was very good.
There was talent there for sure.
Yeah.
You ever think that
as far as musicals go, it was pretty solid, I guess.
You ever think that people might be like helping you through life because you're retarded?
No.
And like
I've kind of thought that.
And like, hey, buddy, don't even worry, you're all right, buddy.
Is that stemming from like the three fucking episodes where you couldn't stop burping?
No, I'm just saying like this.
You're gonna
die. This is a thought that pops up every now and then. It's like, do I have a touch of something?
Oh, I thought you meant like, are you like hallucinating? Like, are you actually?
Oh, maybe you
stupid?
Are. Now you're scared.
Are
of
you
the hell
actually
out of
stupid? But you think everything is normal?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, what if that happens?
Yeah, think about that.
Have you done with Jordan again?
No. No, Jordan's argument would be, you know what, none of this exists anyway. I'm just, when I die, I'm just going to wake up.
I was meaning to talk about that. I got about 100 kilometers away from Jordan. I just kind of winked out of existence. Should I be bothered by that?
I started flashing and it told me to return to my combat zone or something. Yeah. Return to the story area.
Like, any time I try to leave Newfoundland, it's all just, like, flat images. It's terrible. The draw distance sucks.
Just become energy
just
and
low
light.
Poly, low-poly environment effects.
That actually kind of reminded me of an idea I had a few episodes
ago. Jesus, calm down, Sirens.
Dude with Siren, go buy the house already, for fuck's sake. So we saw a guy in a bicycle.
Their ambulance is coming. Look out for the ambulance.
Budget cuts, guys. We got a bicycle. And then I lay down his helmet.
Budget cuts.
The actual sirens are right next to his ears.
All the guys actually dead for once? Or they got to pop out of the poker
table? They'll definitely pop out of the thing.
They're going to pop out.
What if they made a game? A video game where,
you know, blackjack.
You weren't the main character. You were...
There's a lot of tables here, dude.
That's roulette.
Sorry, go ahead, Aaron.
A game where you're not the main character, you're friends with the player character. And the player character is like super smart AI and does the objective just fast. But you're like an NPC character, but that's who you play as. So you see, like when he runs
but
another
room...
But
that wouldn't be the player character then.
No, but that's not who you play. I'm talking about like... In a normal game like this, like James Bond is the player character. I'm talking about where you play as like one of the enemy guys.
What beer do they have on top?
So,
what? Let's find out.
Where, like, you see, like, the level despawn because he ran into another area. And you just, like, you become the game rather than the player character. So you, like, this area is going to despawn when he goes there. This area is going to load. It pop. Like, I don't know how the mechanics would work, but I think it'd just be
interesting. That would actually
concept.
Be interesting, but I don't think that you could do it yet.
Maybe not. But, like, you control the game rather than the player, if you know what I'm saying. Right? You win by being the game.
Look at this girl. Like one of your French right. girls. Quick, before I wink out of
I think it's an interesting idea. I think it would be...
Don't
make that door open.
I think it would be more interesting to see, like, an actual narrative game where you don't play as the hero. You play alongside the hero.
Oh, yeah.
Like,
I mean,
Great
this
Gatsby.
Was an idea that I just fired it in my
it's
head.
Sort of Great Gatsby, right?
Like, yeah, I guess, yeah.
I didn't see that, so... I don't know.
Except it would have to be redone with not shit.
Oh, you didn't see the 2013 Great Gatsby?
There was other ones?
Yeah, there's the original Great Gatsby.
Oh, man, you got fucking reamed apart.
That dude crept up on you and put his gun right to Bond's
The 2013 Great Gatsby was done by... Cinematography was done by Simon Dugan, who's a boss. And y'all know I really like Simon Dugan.
Hey, let Adam see.
I'm not giving you that. I'm not giving you that.
He used to be all black.
Got fucking... I got these Buckyball magnet things, and Adam ruined it. I made it into a D20, and then Adam ruined it. And then suddenly I fixed it.
It's like, oh, that's...
It's magnets. It's not solid.
I think the Winter Soldier should throw around explosive Buckyballs that stick to things.
I get it.
Yeah.
Do you get it, Adam?
Stupid.
Winter Soldier should throw Buckyballs? Do you get it?
Why would he throw his ball sack around? Does he call his scrotum buckyballs?
Yeah.
Because they're microscopic?
And they're magnetic.
Do people usually have a name for their scrotum?
Oh, I do.
I could see that being a thing.
I call mine Rory.
That would be weird.
I actually don't.
What do you mean would be?
some girls Sorry. Named their boobs, though.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah. I've never named any of my parts.
I don't know if that's actually true or not, or just something
like
that sounds
fucking
plausible. Like
Righty and Lefty.
Shit!
I don't know, like Pointy and Saggy or something.
Just look at my hands, like L. Shit! I've been wrong. All
I don't
time.
Name anything.
Quick, call the plane back. I gave
that's
him
a
wrong directions.
Start naming stuff.
Yeah, Rory, name your penis. And then you can just throw the name around in conversation and nobody knows what the fuck you're talking about. Like, oh, I'm just hanging out with George today. Just, you know, just turfing it. Like, wait. Right.
What is it? In House of Lies? That she was like, if you guys say anything, I'm cutting off O. Henry, Supa Dupa, and Knight Rider.
Which are the
names of their respective junk.
Why do you look at girls?
Okay, I'm going to go to Yahoo Answers.
What is Adam doing?
We're all doing different things.
I've never named my boobs. I have a very big female friendship group, too. I neither.
Neither have they.
Oh no, get cover. Jesus.
Yeah, but I feel like one small community of girls that don't name their breasts is not representative of the entirety
listen,
of the
I'm
female
going
population.
Into multiple forms.
Okay, look, what I'm saying is I know girls
as
who
we
name
all
their
should.
Boobs.
Right, yeah, Aaron is saying that his experience
I know girls that have named their boobs. I'm not saying that everybody does it.
Naming your boobs.
Boy, it'd be great if there was crouch.
That's like
game.
A big responsibility.
My
you gotta naming a kid is all well and good.
I don't think it's something.
But you've only
got to
come up with one name for your child.
You don't address.
You need two names. For
you don't
your
address them all the
need
time.
They to last your entire life.
I don't. You don't address them all the time, though. It's like maybe it comes
yeah,
up
always,
as a joke
they're always
in
there in the back of your mind. You've always got to remember your boobs.
I agree.
So
I agree with
so
Andrew. I think it's a huge hassle.
See,
at least when you name your kid, you don't have to live with the name.
That's
but if you name
point.
Your boobs, you got to live with those names, man.
You don't.
So just listen to this.
You
no
have,
fucking
those are your names.
Just fucking listen.
What?
I named mine the Titans.
Oh,
and
that's creative.
Ruby Lips named hers the Pointer Sisters. Named
that's
mine Roland
awful.
Foley.
Terrible job.
Name mine Bill and Ted because they have many excellent adventures.
Bill and Ted is good.
It's okay.
It's alright. It's shit.
What do they
yeah,
do?
Most of those names are terrible.
Do
a better
do
job.
About all the things that come between them?
I named mine Bought and Paid For.
B-O-T, that's a stupid name.
Oh! I meant to say something about bots. So me and my friend Tim were talking about
here we
bots
go.
The other day.
Is this? Were you waiting ben for this conversation Jerry. To happen?
Yeah.
Were you waiting for the specific line of dialogue
oh, yeah, I got
to
something
happen?
I got
so
something
you could get on the topic of bots.
Well, speaking of purchased titties, I got something to talk about.
So me and my friend Tim were talking about bots the other day, and what this originated from an idea I had earlier. So
like
what it
AI
happened was,
bots like.
Yeah,
like bots in a game?
Like in real life bots. So, no, I'll explain
like
this
robots?
A little better. Sorry. No. So, two people added me on Facebook, and
oh.
I didn't know either of them.
The
but
last
I,
thread on the last post on the thread was, we need more boob threads.
I didn't have any mutual friends with either of them, so I checked their respective friends lists. And the only people on their friends list I recognized were each other. And my friend JP was there, and he said, well, a bot is friends with another bot. And that got me thinking, and I was saying this to Tim, about how many bots are friends with other bots. And then that got me thinking. Like, I wonder if there's a circle of, like, 15 bots all friends with each other.
Get the cover, you idiot.
They're also friends with a real person. And that real person thinks those 15 bots are his friends. And he's throwing a party. And he thinks 15 of his friends are coming. But they're not, because they're bots.
I wonder if accept party invitations?
That would be hilarious if bots accepted invites to
things. Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
oh, great! I got 40 people coming. Nobody shows up.
That's conceivable to me. And do the bots have conversations? Tim was saying, like, do they say, like, win a free iPad, win a free iPad, win a free iPad? They just keep going back and forth. Like, it's. I wonder. I want to study the network of social network bots.
I smell an Adam Sandler movie. Friends.
He plays all the bots.
Friends with beta bots.
Friends with bots, or bots with benefits.
What's Adam Sandler's situation,
bots
anyways? Like, what's
he's making money off literal feces?
What's his deal,
oh,
though?
Lisa Greens.
Like, his movies weren't always what they are.
Because he has his own production company now, and he can literally just fucking approve garbage. Like, yeah, let's make that. Fuck it.
Grown Ups 2.
Yeah. Grown Ups 3. Bots.
Oh
with
my
benefits.
Jesus.
Turns out everybody but Adam Sandler is a robot.
That's good. Click 2
great.
Or something.
And then at
the
end...
one human
at,
is Adam
fuck
Sandler.
Your kidney.
At the end, the twist is Adam Sandler is also a robot.
The twist is he's the only robot.
Ah. Throughout the whole movie...
Who programmed that guy?
Throughout the whole movie, he thinks he's the only one that's not a robot, but at the end, it turns
it's
out
like
he
that,
is the robot.
It's like that Dave Chappelle skit where he's a white supremacist and he's a black
yeah.
guy.
It's like that Dave funny. Chappelle skit where... It turns out he was the robot the whole time.
Crouch. I would like Crouch in this game.
Yeah, James Bond hasn't learned that, though.
Hope this doesn't take me out of Reddit.
Maybe in a few more game companies that get closed down because this is their last project,
continue.
They'll figure out how to implement crouching mechanics.
If we're lucky, Aaron.
How long to go here? Jesus. We've been stuck in this one corridor for like a half an hour. Just run down the main bit.
Do you think Michael Jordan ever regrets his life?
No.
Oh my
what?
Jesus.
Is Michael Jordan?
Get behind cover.
Do you, Do you think he lives regret-free?
Who's Michael Jordan?
Yes, 100%.
Hey, look, no doing gold plaques.
Michael Jordan is...
What is that? What is that no, don't do something.
Found my new favorite
subreddit. Go to the left. On Wilder. Go in. Nope. Go left. Go that way. Oh, you're getting shot.
Hang on. This might melt the eyes out of the back of the skull.
Dude, don't do sign. What is that? What is that?
You gotta be...
I don't know.
No idea. Cool. What is... Oh, man. You those are titties.
Adam's just looking at boobs.
Yeah, what... What was the context for that, Adam?
I wanted to go...
How deep into the internet did you go, Adam?
After,
Up Anna Kendrick photos, Adam just pulling up boob gifs.
He just went to r/titty drop.
Here, just do, here, do this.
What was I looking up?
Pull those up here.
Oh, I was looking up if women named their boobs, and it led to a Reddit post, and that led to another Reddit, and that led to another subreddit.
Yeah, you're fucking, I'll just watch porn.
And this is, anyway, after a couple of subreddits, I became here.
Yeah.
Count the bounce.
By led to, Adam means...
What subreddit was that one on?
He googled if girls named their boobs, and then he typed in r/titty drop.
Is that an actual subreddit?
Yes.
Is it titty drop?
Titty drop. r/titty drop.
That does not surprise me that that is a
it's
subreddit.
It's where girls drop their titties.
It's pretty much a subreddit for everything now.
Instead of dropping the base, they drop their dudes. Their boobs.
Their dudes.
Their boob. Dude.
Is it the same girl?
It might be.
That's same as what?
As well.
No.
I think hers are larger than the one Adam was maybe. Looking at.
That's not the same person.
Not that it...
Rory knows all about
it. Size matters, right, ladies?
Based on size and mass and also skin tone and fucking, I don't know.
Poor, cuticles.
Based on poor dilation, not same woman.
Based on cuticles of the breast.
Breast cuticles?
Yeah.
Jesus. Fucking like fingernail pieces coming out of your nipples.
Holy shit.
Well, I mean, you guys have like a calcium shell over your nipples, right?
Shell? What do you call those things? Those like areola protectors?
Pasties?
Yeah, there you go. Those are calcium clumps.
No, there's actually a name for them when runners use them.
What?
Are they things?
Yeah, runners use those.
Are they afraid to get their like nipples too
I guess
cold?
It chafes. Their shirt chafes.
That's precisely right.
That's never happened to me.
Yeah, so they...
Why don't they run shirtless?
Also, I don't run anywhere, though.
They have, like, protection for that. The,
But don't...
No one runs shirtless.
Dudes, right, like dudes, right? Absolutely people
early
run shirtless.
Early humans did.
I mean shirtless, not shirtless.
They managed to live.
No, they didn't. They died of vitamin deficiency quite promptly.
Well, all humans eventually die.
Yeah, all humans are dead now, and there's no more.
What I'm saying...
Wait, Adam went way too deep in the internet, apparently. He just needed to get out of the internet, apparently.
What I'm saying is, early humans may have died from vitamin deficiencies, but they didn't die because their nipples chafed.
That's a good point.
Evolution is fucking stupid. Why do humans need so many goddamn
vitamins?
You were looking at prolapsed anuses again, weren't you?
Yeah, fucking prolapsed anus drops.
Wonder if that's a subreddit.
You know what? I was watching something the other night.
I'm not gonna say what it was.
Okay.
I'm not gonna say what it was, but it was like a hard cut to...
It's a hard something.
It was a hard cut to a girl... Just like super close up camera, and it's just like, and it was gross.
The
it was so bad.
Know what your hand gesture was? Why don't you explain it a little?
It was a fist going into an anus by the look of it.
No. It was stuff coming out of the anus is what it was, and going back in and coming back out.
That's
how you push
the anus.
Apparently, after your anal sex, you can't feel anything, so you can't even feel your own guts coming out of you. That's what happens.
Well, that was one of the more disturbing noises you've ever made, probably in your life.
I regretted every second of it.
Bit of a slapper at the end.
Is there anything else we could talk about? But we have to segue. It has to be somewhat related.
So segues.
I was in cover, dude.
Oh my god, he's fucking freaking out.
He got shot in the spine, so his body, the body's twitching. Oh, you're looking at cats?
I'm looking at it's the
cat
this
porn.
This Reddit is called cutest things on the internet.
Yeah, Adam needs to like not be on the one he was on before.
Look at the eye bleach.
Adam only pulls up the ones that have girls.
No, it's just this. It's just cute animals.
Oh, yeah.
It's for when you see something gross.
r/Florida Man is
pretty
good.
Yeah, I'm sure
that's what
it
is. I swear to God.
Did you bring it up on your phone?
Okay, I will.
Does anyone go on r/Florida Man? Andrew, you probably do.
I have, yeah.
Fucking Florida Man.
Oh, that is adorable.
Fucking Flora, Florida. Flora.
Yeah, that's baby sea lion.
It's an animal.
I wonder if there's a Reddit dinosaur Reddit.
I guarantee there is. There's a dinosaur. There's an everything Reddit.
Nope, incorrect. There's no Pixel Junkies Reddit.
There probably is. One of the fans probably started one.
Oh, yeah. That's Rory with a fake account.
Oh, it's an elephant! I like those.
You like elephants?
Oh, eye bleach is only for when you've seen gross things on the internet, and right now I need all of it.
Or is it just people who pour bleach into their eyes? And then they go blind.
Go on r/waifuism. That one's interesting.
No, thanks. No. Fuck Reddit most of the time, to be honest.
So, I never talked about this, like, on one of the shows.
There's like 1,000 magazines on
the
floor right
there. I was talking to a friend the other day, and he finds the idea of, like, waifu kind of unusual. And,
As you should. As humanity
and
should.
So it was interesting, because I have a friend who has a friend who has a waifu.
Oh, that's cool.
And so I have a waifu number of 2, my distance from a waifu. And he has a waifu number of 3, and he was really
uncomfortable. Can we talk about this on the podcast?
The proximity. No, we talked about it in Tim Hortons after the podcast. That interests me. So, like, you guys also now have a waifu number of 3. How does that make you feel?
I don't give a fuck.
I don't know him, so I don't care.
Man.
Tell me when I get to waifu 1, and then I'll care. Then I will care about
it. Then you'll have a waifu.
Oh, okay.
Apparently
2
then. Apparently you
Or I guess, you're right. Favorite. No, waifu number of 0 is having waifu.
Okay.
So waifu number of 1, you will care, though.
You spoke waifu?
Waifu is W-A-I-F-U.
W-A-F-F-L-E.
W-A-I-F-U.
What Aaron was spelling was
just awful.
Just
to point out, bullets don't do that.
Yeah, yes, they do.
They absolutely do not.
Have you ever been shot at by bullets?
I'm constantly shot at. I'm shot by verbal bullets, Aaron, on a daily basis.
You see all kinds of shots.
I'm neoing the fuck out of these things.
Dodging
day,
comments.
Dodging these verbal. Oh,
what's that?
What is that, Adam?
Oh man,
was that a guy and his waifu and his sword?
Yeah,
he's
somebody
cool
made fun
guy.
Of my waifu once.
That's pretty funny.
All right, well we can end.
Please.
So his waifu is the second one from the right.
Cool. He's a cool
guy.
Are you on waifu or waifuism?
I'm on waifu.
Oh, waifu is more of like a joke Reddit. Waifuism is like the serious waifu people.
Oh.
That makes sense.
Waifu.
It's all bad.
I
it's all
you were
terrible.
Saying Wi-Fi.
It's not a good thing. It's not healthy. It's not productive. Do something better with your lives.
Oh, yeah.
Get up. Run, and get healthy.
I mean, it
from me personally, because I'm a health god. And I'll let you know this much. If you wake up every morning and you look in the mirror and you hate yourself and you love your waifu, there's something universally wrong with that.
What if you love yourself
humanity,
and you love your waifu?
If you love yourself and you love the person that you're with and who is not a pillow.
They're not pillows, they're characters who are on
Stop
pillows.
Stop being anti-progressive against pillow people, man.
You know what? I'm sorry. If you guys want to transform yourselves and your bodies into pillows to be how you truly feel, feel free to, as long as you're not hurting anybody else.
Yeah, I mean, I make fun of waifus, but that's all in fun. I honestly don't care. If you're into that kind of stuff, then more power to him.
Yeah, rock on, dude.
I'm really into dinosaurs, and people think that's just as stupid, so who am I to judge? So.
See, my definition of waifu is when you steal someone's internet connection without them knowing.
So,
that's
you know
what waifu is.
I'm making fun, but I don't actually mean it.
I do.
Oh. Alright, good, you
don't
died.
Be weird.
Bye!
Bye!